In the year 2525, if man is still alive, if woman can survive, they may find.
Howdy, rabble rousers. We're back, as usual. Today, yeah, I know. It's usually how it goes here. But today, we wanted to do just a little refresher of a past video that we've done. Just the New Jersey compliant AR-15, New Jersey legal AR-15, whatever you want to call it. And we just kind of wanted to rehash certain things that we've talked about in that video. Some things have changed since then. And like we're always going to say, some things probably will change after this. So this is as of this filming of today's video, what is legal. But you can, like we've talked about in other videos, get these in Jersey. They're not unheard of. There's plenty of them out there. There's certain things that have to be done to the gun to make it compliant in Jersey. And so a couple of those things that have to be done are the stock has to be pinned. So this is, you can't move this.
Yeah.
Essentially, it's in a specific spot where, you know, you're comfortable with it. You can get your optics. You can kind of acquire the sight. And that's where they pin it. The next thing is there's no barrel, there's no barrel lug, bayonet lug, sorry, present. This one's a free float rail, so if you have one that's like, you know, got an A2 front sight and it's got a barrel, bayonet lug, they have to shave that off. And then the last thing is just really the muzzle device. The muzzle device has to be pin and welded on there, and it's got to be like a muzzle brake. So that's really, you know, what we want. We've talked about in past videos. You know, feel free to refer to that video for like a, you know, we show kind of the entire rifle and stuff like that. The only thing that's changed since that video is now you have to have 10 round mag. So, you know, typically like a 30 round mag, like yeah, this they size, modify they modify them, then they put like a pin in them.
Modify them to 10, yeah.
So that's really the only thing that's changed since that video. We also wanted to talk about that, you know, in Jersey, there are other options, if you will.
Yes.
Now they've come out with the these others. These are, you know, they call them other firearms. So what they do is they actually, they don't fall in the category as a rifle. They don't fall in the category as a pistol. We did a whole kind of spiel on this whole stuff. They fall in this other category. And so what it is actually a shorter configuration, still an AR-15, guys. It's a shorter configuration. It's got like a pistol brace on it as opposed to a stock.
Yeah.
It looks like a stock. It functions kind of like a stock.
Pistol brace,
but it's a pistol brace, exactly. You don't have to have it pinned. You don't have to have any of that sort of stuff done. You can have it collapsible, that sort
of
stuff.
Go figure.
Yep. You can have a true on certain ones, you can have a true flash hider on them. It's just that certain ones, if it's 10.5 inches on certain configurations, like Troy makes one, it has to be pinned and welded because it adds to the overall length of the gun. But if you get like a 12.5 inch barreled other firearm, you can actually have that where that doesn't have to be pinned and welded. So I have to have 10 round mags, obviously. But since it falls in this other category, none of this compliancy work really has to be done. So it's, you know, virtually the same gun, other than the fact that, you know, it's a little bit shorter configuration, has a vertical front grip on it, which you're not supposed to take off.
Yeah.
Has the pistol brace on it, which you're not supposed to take
and
off.
And your muzzle device
and,
is not pinned and welded.
And the muzzle
either,
device is
so
not pinned.
Now
and
you have a threaded barrel. Along.
Exactly. So
it gives you more versatility.
That's really all we
for other
know,
muzzle
want
devices.
To talk about. But yeah, there's other than the fact that you can get an AR-15 in a full-size configuration and have that work done to it, there are other options in Jersey. There's the ones where you can get other firearms. Troy makes them. LWRC makes a few. Now some down in Keyport, Jersey, Modern Material makes them.
That's kind of cool, guys, right? Down
right,
in Jersey.
Right, from Jersey. You know,
that,
you can
I
get
would
those.
Support them. I mean,
absolutely.
How's the price point on that?
And
pretty
those,
good?
Those are, they're all right around, like, you know, like, $1,000 range, like, just over $1,000, $1,300. Those are right around there. So, you know, you can get definitely different sort of configurations.
That,
it's all like Magpul furniture, and you got like an SP tactical brace on all those. So, you know, they anodize them, and you can get them in like bronze, titanium, black, whatever color you want.
That's cool.
But yeah, there's tons of, you know, these options that are kind of floating around, and it's great that that's out there, you know what I mean? They're
what I'm saying.
Awesome.
Get them while they can, because pretty soon, guys, your ARs, you're going to It's going to have like in New Jersey, whether they may even get rid of them, but it's going to have that, what is that, like connector that they put here.
Oh,
it's almost like becomes like a stock.
Yeah,
so
they don't
it's
want
like
a pistol,
totally,
pistol
yeah,
grip
yeah, it just yeah. becomes like a stock, like yeah. a like if it was a full
exactly,
stock.
Exactly, like a rifle stock, or like a,
you know,
that, like a bolt action rifle
yeah,
stock.
That pistol grip keeps you from getting it taken away or falling out of your hand easy,
yeah.
you know? Yeah, definitely. Because, yeah, the fact that we can get these in New Jersey, even like when we were talking about the shockwaves some time ago,
yeah.
You know, these are really awesome firearms that give you more versatility than you've ever had before.
Absolutely.
I know with AR, I guess to get it as compact as possible, you had to go with a 14-inch barrel, which I know LWRC makes them, but it would have a 1.5-inch flash hider or muzzle device on the end, so you got the 16 inches, but you actually did end up overall with a more compact
exactly. And that's,
rifle.
That's another thing that I forgot to mention about the other firearms is, so most of those are coming in like 12-inch barrels, 10.5-inch barrels, so that's essentially
awesome.
Like a pistol AR that you can get here in Jersey, but obviously it's not a pistol AR, they classify it as this other firearm, so it's in this like special category, which I find hilarious, but it's that short of a configuration. It's like 27 inches overall, like most of them. So I mean, they're short configurations, like a rifle like this. I mean, you're probably looking at, like, you know, significantly more.
Yeah,
for
I would say
getting,
it's probably about 3 feet.
Yeah, so I mean, it's not that it's impossible to, like, you know, if you really needed to like maneuver around like a place, it's not impossible, but it's easier with a shorter configuration.
Yeah, well, especially if you're inside a vehicle
or
something like that. Yeah, I know you can't carry your
not in Jersey, yeah,
but,
exactly.
But anyway, you could, I mean, you know. But,
if you needed, if shit really hit the fan, you needed to.
You know, stuff like that, definitely, yeah, but.
Yeah, but that's, you know, we just wanted to do like a little refresh on that, you know, and kind of rehash what we've talked about in the past. Feel free to refer back to that video. You know, we kind of go a little bit more in depth to where, you know, they're not really showing how they do it, but they like pinning the stock and like, the muzzle device and stuff like that.
Yeah,
so.
You guys have to do your research too on, you know, I mean, you can get not a flash hider, but a muzzle device. Compensator.
Muzzle, yeah.
They're not all created equal, guys. They don't all do things like, I mean, first off, some do, you know, mitigate flash to a degree, but it's marginal, and it's not like a true flash hider, and you're also going to give it up on concussion.
Yeah.
You know, the gun's going to be louder.
Yeah.
You know, things of that nature, but you know, you have to just do your research. There's hundreds of them out there probably. Mm-hmm. And like I said, some are better than others, but I would just, you know.
Yeah.
It's what will matter to you, I would keep in mind. So if you don't mind noise, then you could probably give up a little bit less light signature than, you know, go
absolutely.
With that hider. If you want less noise, then you're gonna have to give up something. That's how it seems to me that those things work.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and just one more thing to note too, that most people that, you know, I've seen lately at least, who are, you know, looking to get their first AR, get into like the AR sort of platform in Jersey, they're not going with full length rifles, only because a lot of that compliancy work is taken out of the factor. You're talking, you know, if someone's looking to get an AR, you know, the basic rifles aren't cheap either, and when you're talking about the others, I mean, you're talking about 3 or 4 inches worth of barrel length, as opposed to, you know, as a full rifle. I mean, so really,
plus,
you're not talking about much.
Plus, keep in mind that pistol brace is collapsible,
and
too.
Exactly, and you don't have to have any of the, like
so
I said, the compliancy work done to it. You can have the collapsible pistol brace. You can have the interchangeable flash hider on there. You can have a true flash hider. So people who are getting into them are just veering more towards the other firearms because a lot of that stuff is taken out of the equation in Jersey. So get them while you can, because that's probably gonna be the next thing that they either ban by name, or they say that anything classified as another firearm is illegal, or who knows what. So
the ATF guys has gone kooky. They're giving them a lot of authority. They're just another freaking bureaucracy bullshit branch that you know, should not be doing. They shouldn't even exist, but they should most certainly not be doing the things they're doing now. So God only knows. Like I said, with all the craziness going. Also, I just wanted to mention one last thing with AR-15s One thing is for certain that it's good to point out is that it's amazing how short you can get this gas system and this gun still functions reliably. This gun is so versatile in so many different ways, I can't even explain it.
Yep.
Other than the fact that you just need to fucking wipe its ass. It needs to be babied.
Yep.
But that fact alone
great,
is just
great gun.
Unbelievable. And and you're not giving up a lot in the accuracy department either.
Mm-hmm.
With, you know, you're still...
With shorter configurations.
No,
yeah,
you're
absolutely.
Not. You're not.
Yeah.
You know, get a good... I mean, I definitely have sights. You know, metal is preferable. I have these Magpul that they're plastic, but you can get metal ones. But a good red dot or a good, you know, optic with a lot of glass, like, you know...
Like an EOTech.
Yeah, well, EOTech or Aimpoint, if you're in that price point, or like maybe
Sigs.
Like a Romeo
5 nice,
or something. Yeah, Sig, like those. Otherwise, then you go into another whole crazy price point and stuff.
Yeah.
But if you're going to have one rifle, I'd put a good optic on.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, if you're going to have a few that you're going to play with, then I can understand, you know, you're getting like, you know, something, whatever, just to play around with. But so I hope everybody has their hand sanitizer.
If you don't,
and,
you can't get it anymore.
and canned soup and who knows what next.
That's, you know, we'll definitely touch on that in a future video as far as what's going on now with this coronavirus and all this other kind of nonsense.
Guys,
but that's going to cause some ruckus, and we've already seen it causing a lot of stuff. So
this is what we've been talking about now.
Yeah.
Something's here now, so.
Yep.
This is when we're going to see the...
stay clean!
The good people survive the bad people.
Yeah.
You know?
It's crazy. I walked into a couple stores this past weekend, and I mean, the toilet paper aisle, maybe not aisle, but section, all sold out. Hand sanitizer, all sold out. Mm-hmm. And I was just in there just, you know, food shopping, just kind of getting some stuff for the kind of the week and stuff, but... People were going crazy, and I was blown away by that. But
shit, I'll start using my clothes if I can't wipe my ass. I'll
use
cut-up t-shirts.
and
I gotta wipe my ass.
And as far as hand sanitizer, just get some, like, good whiskey, you know?
Yeah.
And then
absolutely.
You're good.
Yeah, but it goes to show you guys how much control, like, that this government has over people to scare them like this.
Well, not only that, too. It's just that it goes to show you how... small of something that happens and how much people panic. I mean, if something, this is not to say that I'm not trying to downplay it or anything like that, but imagine if something were to really happen where,
like, a meteor to hit
something crazy. And I mean, these stores would be ransacked for everything that's inside of them. So
they're already, like, restricting supplies and stuff like that, or limiting what people can buy and stuff like that. They're not,
we'll talk more about that.
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah. Let's not,
Yeah, we wanted to just do a rehash of the AR-15.
Yeah.
Hopefully that
just make sure you have the stuff you need, guys. Other
make
than
sure
that,
you get one of these.
Yeah, oh yeah, exactly.
You need one of these for the coronavirus too, if you didn't know that. It'll save you from a lot.
Yeah. Right.
Cheers, guys. Thanks for tuning in.
Take care. Don't
we'll
get quarantined.
Yes.
Good night, Rabble Rousers.